This is a safety tip brought to you by the Certified Horsemanship Association. I'm Julie Goodnight, and this is an AQHA gilding by the name of Smokin' Coronas. I'm here to talk to you today about saddling the Western horse. We've already groomed this horse, made sure he's really clean and smooth from nose to tail. We paid particular attention underneath the belly of the horse where you can't always see what's happening under there. Make sure there's no dirt or debris caked underneath his belly. So we've got them all groomed up. We're ready to saddle now. So first comes the pad. I want to, of course, make sure my pad is clean, both on the top side and particularly on the bottom side, the part of the pad that's going to be next to the horse. Make sure there's no debris or stickers or caked on dirt. So that all looks pretty good. I want to put the saddle pad on pretty high up on the horse's neck and then slide it back into place. That way it'll smooth the hair down as we slide that pad back. If I put the pad on too far back and slide it forward, it's going to rough up the hair under the pad, and that could cause back soreness in your horse. So I'll square my pad up, make sure it's plenty far forward, then I'm ready for the saddle. There's lots of different ways to get that saddle up on the horse, depending on how big your horse is and how big you are. Sometimes a Western saddle's a little heavy, it's hard to get up there. So we all have our different techniques for coping with that. I like to sling the saddle on the horse I use a little bit of centrifugal energy to help spread those stirrups and the cinch up wide. So I'm going to start back here and just lift and swing the saddle on the horse. And then I want to square up my pad, pull the pad well up into the gullet of the saddle. I want to have more pad in front of the saddle than behind the saddle. If you have too much pad behind the saddle, your pad's going to tend to slip out the back. So I'll pull the pad up into the gullet of the saddle to create an airspace under the over the wither of the horse. And I just want to come around to make sure it's squared up here in the back with the center of the saddle, the center of the pad, and the horse's spine all in alignment. I'm going to carefully walk around the back side of the horse to check everything over here. Make sure there's no strings under the saddle. Make sure everything is square and straight. I'm going to release the cinch from the offside, checking the billet strap, and make sure everything's clean, in good condition, and straight. So I'll let this hang down. I don't want to go too far away from my horse right now because this saddle is not attached to the horse, and it could really scare him if he were to move and the saddle were to fall. So I'm going to stay real close and try to keep a hand on this saddle to make sure it stays where it needs to be. I'll put the stirrup up over the horn just to get it out of the way. And as I come back here, to reach up and grab the cinch, I want to make sure that I'm facing forward when I reach up underneath the horse so that if this horse were to kick at any time, it'd be my backside he hits and not the front side. So if I stand forward to get to grab the cinch, I'm getting my head down in the kick zone of the horse. So it's far safer to stand facing forward with your backside to the rear feet of the horse, reach under, grab that cinch and bring it up. Now I've got the latigo all ready to just pull straight down here, and we're going to fasten the cinch, not too tight at first, just enough to snug it up and make sure the saddle's going to stay in place. Good. Now, if your horse is uncomfortable with the cinch, gets fussy about cinching, it's a good idea to just release him from the tie rail before you fasten the cinch. This horse has no problems with being saddled, so he's fine with it. If you have a horse that's fussy, irritable about being saddled and cinched, it's a good idea to untie him just so you don't increase the potential for the horse pulling back and causing a bigger wreck. So I'm gonna just lightly fasten the cinch for now. I'm not ready to step up on this horse. I've got quite a few more things to do first. I don't wanna tighten the cinch too much too fast. If I've not tightened the cinch all the way, so this horse is not ready to be mounted, I usually either leave the stirrup up or leave the latigo hanging down so that if anybody else comes along, they know this horse isn't ready to step up on until he has that cinch tightened. So I'll give one last check, make sure the saddle is where I want to be. I might, if this were a horse that was irritable about being saddled, I might walk him around a little bit before I tighten the cinch any farther so that he gets some comfort level with it. But once we're ready to tighten the cinch the final way, this cinch has holes and a buckle, so I'm going to pull it up, put the leather latigo into the buckle, and then I want to pull back up here to lock that buckle into place. So if we're using the buckle to hold the cinch, we've got a lot of latigo left over. There should be a latigo keeper on your saddle. We're just going to run it through there and pull it slack, and that just stows the latigo out of your way and keeps it out of the way of the leg of the rider. Now, many people prefer to ride with just the buckle to hold the cinch, and that's fine as long as you've got it buckled well. But some people, for an additional level of safety, prefer to have a cinch knot as well. So to tie this cinch knot, I'm simply going to go through the D-ring one more time, and then I'm going to come towards the tail of the horse and back up through the D-ring, and then down in between to lock that cinch into place. To check to see if your cinch is adequately tight, you want to reach down here between the front legs of the horse and stick your finger in from behind. If I can get about one finger in, that cinch is plenty tight. If you can get two or three fingers in there, it's probably a little bit loose. Depending on the shape of your horse, the cinch might need to be tighter or looser. If he's got well prominent withers and it has an A shape to his back, that saddle's not going to tend to slip as much as it will on a rounded horse. So that rounded horse is going to need a little bit tighter cinch. So that's something you need to know about your horse, how tight that cinch needs to be. But one place you don't want to check the cinch is right here. The cinch will always feel loose here because the horse is concave there. So if we reach down between the legs of the horse where the cinch crosses the breastbone of the horse, that's where you'll get an adequate read of how tight the cinch really is. And now we're ready to go. Always you want to check your cinch one more time before you mount the horse, and again 10 minutes into your ride after the horse is warmed up to make sure that cinch is still adequately tight. I'm Julie Goodnight. This is the AQHA Gelding Smokin's Corona, and this is a safety tip brought to you by CHA.